Greetings, fellow Oaklings. Welcome back to some more Elder Scrolls Arena. The last time we left off, we had to, well, look for the next place, the Crypt of Hearts, basically. And there are only three provinces left where we can actually go ahead and check. So I guess we're just gonna have to go ahead and do that. I mean, the last time around, I took around half an hour of time to just walk around and randomly ask people about, you know, where is the Heart of Crypts, and apparently nobody knows, not even the prostitutes or the beggars or the snake charmers or the flamethrowers or anybody, basically. So I guess we're just gonna have to do this on, on our own, the hard way around. So I guess let's get to it. So the three provinces that are still left would be 1. High Rock, 2. Black Marsh, and 3. Morrowind. Now, because of the nature of the name, Crypt of Hearts, I think it is mostly High Rock because it just has that sort of a feel to it. However, it may just be Morrowind as well. I doubt it'll be in Black Marsh, but, well, if we don't find any results, that's where we're gonna go. So let's start off with High Rock, then Morrowind, then Black Marsh. So let's just go over to a random bout of High Rock. I suppose, I don't know, where is should do. Yay, it is day. The port city of Varist hails all weary travelers who wish to rest. Find the strength within our walls to continue your journey, wherever that may be. And traveling actually does make you a little weary. Well, look at that beautiful mountain in the background there. And hello, human. Who are you? They call me Alabain Hearthouse, the Butcher. I chop up huge carcasses into bite-sized bits. And where is the Crypt of Hearts? The only thing I've heard about Crypt of Hearts come from a traveler from Camlorn. Maybe you should start there. Huh, Camlorn. Interesting, let me just go ahead and mark these ints first. I mean, I don't know, I think it's more of an OCD thing with me. I know I'm never gonna come back here, but what the hell. So, yeah, I just do it anyway. So, Camlorn. Where is Camlorn? Ah, right here. Let us hope it is day. Yes, it is. Camlorn, Jewel of the West, greets thee, weary traveler, and bids thee welcome to our city-state. Well, that is good. I mean, I like how I'm really lucking out these days, and this place actually looks quite beautiful. Broad streets, I mean, it looks amazing, to be honest. Huh. I'm guessing you are related to Bulma in some way or the other. Who would you be? You can call me Tristevere Yonesmith. Yonesmith, okay. I'm a toll collector, you know. I assume you already paid thy visitor's tax. Yeah, I guess I have. So, do you know anything about the Crypt of Hearts? The sun must have addled your wits. The Crypt of Hearts is just a legend, and even if it were real, it would be a most dangerous place. If you are bent upon this course, you can of course check the Brotherhood of Seth. It is said that they hold many clues to the location. Alright, so this is basically the first time that we've ever found a quest at... Oh wait, sorry, not that. The temple, the Brotherhood of Seth, southwest of you. Thank you very much. So this is actually the first time we're about to get a quest from... I believe this is the first time around we're about to get a quest from an actual temple instead of like a mage's guild or the queen or king of any hold themselves. So yeah, I suppose I can respect that. No, that's not a temple. That is this is the mage's guild. That would have been a dungeon. No, is it? Yes, it is. Mage's Guild. And this would be an armory. I'm sorry, I'm just walking around marking these places like a lunatic, I know. So wait, southwest you said? You enter the Brotherhood of Seth, and a chill spring breeze follows you, bringing with it the smell of fresh air. You can hear chanting in the distance. It's the one with this sort of a layout. Okay. I welcome you to the Brotherhood of Seth, Grimfangs. Word of your inquiries concerning the Crypt of Arts has come to my attention. Really? Well, I guess word travels faster than I do. I am Halfus Vaughn, senior brother in this temple. I would gladly help you on your quest, but dire times are upon us. One of our brethren, Barnabas of Tethys, went mad, raving that the Emperor had been captured. He has indeed been. He insisted that only something called the Staff of Chaos could free the Emperor from his fate. Well, you're well informed. Naturally, we did not believe him. He was ever one live in fanciful dreams. Instead, we tried our best to soothe him, talking to him of brighter, happier things. We thought he was fine. Yesterday afternoon, he went berserk and killed Brother Martinez, then fled from the temple. With him, he took a scroll that he claimed would help him find a piece of the missing so-called Staff of Chaos. I fear he has gone to the Mines of Khuras, the place where he claimed the map said he would find the first clue. What he doesn't realize is that the map he carries was originally found in the mines. Part of the inscription on the map is a code that we plan to use to decipher the location of the Crypt of Hearts from the Elder Scrolls. Without that map, we haven't a chance. If only there was a way of recovering the map, but the Mines of Khuras are too dangerous. Poor Brother Barnabas has surely perished by now. I will tell you how to get to the mines. There you can search for the map or Brother Barnabas. I think it is highly unlikely you will find either, but there is always a slim chance. If you return to me with the map, I will tell you the location of the Crypt of Hearts. It is a fool's errand, but such is your only hope. Do you wish to search the mines? Yes, of course. I thought you would decline. Faced with the danger of the mines, lava pools and fire pits are scattered throughout its scorched corridors, okay? That's a hint that we need to get some potions of resist fire. You must find something to protect you from the heat of its fires. Hopefully, you will find both Brother Barnabas and the map. I'm willing to bet I'll find Brother Barnabas, alright. His corpse. No matter the mines of Khuras are located near Camlorn, if you find the map, return here to the Brotherhood of Seth. I will tell you the location of the Crypt of Arts. Brother Halfus gestures and you see on your map the location of the mine of Khuras magically appear. Well, this dude is a mage. Well, I mean, when it comes to these guys, I can take their adventures. I can accept their, what do you call them, their requests, their pleas for help, because they're just priests. They're not exactly warriors or mages who can't defend themselves. I mean, they can defend themselves, but as far as a quest like this is concerned, yeah, that's more of an impossibility than something that's, you know, all too plausible. But as far as, you know, the queen or the king or the mages guild is concerned, they are perfectly capable of going on inquisitions and stuff like that. So I don't really understand why they actually ask me for help or keep asking me for help. So I guess this would be the palace here. Not that I mean to go inside, but just, can I identify you? No? Well, okay, if you say so. This place actually looks quite beautiful. I think I might, you know, once I decide to retire, I might just plan on building a home here. Looks super beautiful. The Mine of Khuras. Let me just save the game here quickly. Huh. The sulfuric air of the Mine of Khuras, it's... I guess I'm not supposed to read that? I mean, I am supposed to read that, but I just guess that, you know, it's a little too... It's supposed to be a little too fast for me to read. Don't drop into the lava. This body, you surmise, is that of an unlucky adventurer. The flesh seems torn and perhaps chewed. Scrawled in blood on the floor, next to it are the letters SW. Southwest, you mean? So I suppose that is where we go, to southwest. Let us just mark this body, and then we should loot it. And a torque. 36 gold pieces and a torque. But the question is, how do we proceed southwest? I mean, the only way we can see here doesn't exactly head southwest, now does it? I mean, I think I see a way there, but yeah, I'm gonna have to swim through the fire, which I don't want to do, so... What do we do now? There doesn't really seem to be anything much that we can do. I mean, I guess we can try exploring this area. Or I can just use a potion of levitation, perhaps? I mean, I did purchase some. Let me just save it here, and I shall try doing that. Use a potion of levitation. I bought it after, you know, the last, our last crusade. I had to. 49 gold pieces from a spider, seriously? I just wonder how long this levitation spell lasts. I mean, I could probably pop in like a potion of resist fire and keep swimming, but I'm guessing that is the correct way to go, since it did say south. What the? Who threw a fireball at me? Potion of heal true. This guy? I didn't even see him. Yeah, I mean. Wow, this potion of levitation lasts for quite a long time. That looks like a loot pile, is it? No, it's not. That's a skeleton. I mean, it's making the game look a little weird, you know, with us... What the fuck was that? Bobbing around like this, but yeah, I guess I can sort of see the appeal of... the potion of levitation. It should be somewhere here, I suppose. I mean, this is southwest, so I mean, we just keep heading towards it until we can no longer, I suppose. Potion of heal true again, and I should just save and not empty at this point. Just taking it cautiously. Anything? Oh shit! What the hell, man? What the? So many hellhounds, and it finally... the potion of levitation finally, like, wore off, and... man, that goes on for a long time. I can appreciate that. I can appreciate that. Oh, one of these things again. I don't really like these things, but did it just recharge my stamina? I think it did. Oh, come on, what the hell, man? Oh, shit. Okay, let me just use a potion of heal true again, and... should I? Yeah, yes I should. And, what do I want to use? Yes, a potion of resist fire. You know, I think I'm gonna need a little more than just, yeah, where are the rest? Right here, right? Yeah. Whew. Man, that was rough. Yeah, like I was saying, I think I'm going to need a little more than just... one potion of healing for this. This tunnel seems to be going this way. I think the path we ought to take would be this one here. So, I mean, it did give us the clue to go southwest all the way, so... yeah, I suppose we shall follow that clue. Let me just quickly save again in temp. Not here. These dungeons are all so dank, I mean... they're pretty difficult to see, I mean, where you're actually going, so that's something which always irks me a bit. See, the thing about these hellhounds is that you never know when they will insta-kill you. They launch three attacks in a row, and that's something which a lot of monsters do in this game. But these guys basically launch three attacks in a row, and you never really know when they will actually kill you, so you just need to be a little cautious with them. Like, keep saving as much as you can. Okay. I mean, I heard you guys, but you guys sort of weren't there a moment ago. We need to head this way. Where does this passageway take us? It takes us... down here. I mean, I can try going down it. Wait, let me just... heal first, and also pop in a potion of resist fire, and now I'm gonna save. Excuse me. Save before I drop down this passageway. What the hell was that? You, two of you, come on! No! Where do I want to go? Not this direction, that's for sure. I think I should... Where did they go? I guess they don't follow you after a certain point then. But this area seems to be like a dead end of sorts. So I guess we just try going out this way and going back in, I suppose. I'm not sure. You know what? Alright. I mean, if you're gonna be that persistent, then I have no other choice than to actually obliterate you. So... Oh yeah, so update, I actually got like a second tower shield, and I also got like an adamantium tanto, just in case all my, you know, swords break, and I don't have anything too useful to use against creatures like these. So, here we go. Get ready to die. Column. Suits you. This look really suits you. Nothing usable. Okay. So I guess the only way to truly go down is to follow this path here. And I suppose that is where we go then. Here? Yeah, here. I am going the right way, right? Yes, I am. Let us hope that we make this jump without burning to death. Save the game again. Just for, you know, reasons pertaining to safety, and... let's just stick to this side. I mean, it did say southwest, so... That was... Okay, so that is a lot of zombies. I mean, do you guys really want to, like, give me diseases or, diseases or something? And I suppose... that guy wasn't joking when he said... it is gonna be a rough ride. So, I mean, it has been thus far. Let me just go ahead and re-equip the other weapon. Broadsword of speed, elven longsword of strength. Yes, this was it. I can actually see how magic would be really useful in this game. 50 gold pieces and a zombie. I mean... I did click on it expecting something, but 50 gold pieces, really? And I guess this is the way further down, I would suppose. and there seems to be no enemy here, which is always good. Nobody likes enemies. This seems to be a platform of sorts. How further down can we go? Not much, so I guess we are near the objective. I would like to finish it quickly because, I mean, I don't know. I just feel like I'm spending a lot of time on this game and I just want to, you know, get it over with sooner. But that just might be me, so yeah. So I would take this opportunity to ask all 17 of you. Hey, wait. You're no longer all 17. There are 37 of you now. Sorry, not 37. What am I even saying? 23 of you now. So, yeah. I basically promoted myself on social media, and to my surprise, people actually came over. A few of you guys actually showed that you cared. Amulet and a longsword, which I shall take, because I've got a lot of storage space, and why not? 5 gold pieces, okay. And this seems to be a perfectly fine pool of water, but I shall still save. Is there anything else here? I mean, this is the southwestest corner of the map right here. And is there really nothing here which I can use or take? I mean, it feels good to see water after, you know. Huh. I guess there is nothing here. So what was the point of coming here? You told us to go southwest and we did go southwest. And there's nothing here in southwest. What? Huh. Perhaps it's somewhere around in this vicinity, so I guess exploration might do us some good. I mean, this really does look like... Nah, actually it doesn't. It's not lined with that sort of a wall. Objectives, they have a different colored wall around them to help you identify them whenever you do get near them. So, I guess we'll just keep exploring this way. Are we going the right way? Yeah, we are. You know what? We actually haven't... But I think we have. Haven't we? What the fuck? Ah, yes, you. A major pain in the ass. That's what you are. And one of the things which I don't understand is if everything here is literally scorched, why is it that it's so dark in this dungeon? I mean, everything is literally supposed to be on fire right now, right? And I don't really know whether I'm going the right way or not, but because the dungeons we've been encountering recently have always had more than just one level, but it might just be that this dungeon has only one level. Who knows, right? Wait, what? I cannot travel from here. Did I accidentally? Ah, yeah, I did. Oh yeah, that is something that I wanted to test out the last time. You know what, I guess I'll just drop these. I mean, I don't really have much space for them. Ebony broadsword, longsword, yeah, drop it. I mean, they won't really fetch me a lot of money, so there's no real point in carrying them, and I guess we're fine with the rest. Save here, I suppose, in not empty, I guess. I'm guessing a lot, sorry, but that's just basically how I do things. This game actually has a glitch where it doesn't always render sounds. So it sort of throws me off sometimes because I can't always hear skeletons and well, basically anything until it, you know, ambushes you sort of out of nowhere. Whereas it is supposed to make a sound when it has detected you and is basically stalking you. So where are we right now? So I went through all these places. Is this somewhere I can go? Is this some place that I missed? I think it would be worth going back and checking, but then I'll find you. I guess we'll clear out the outskirts of the map first before heading forward, I guess. Curious. Oh shit, this place actually has two wraiths here. Let me just, use a potion. Whoa, this place has got a lot of loot. Don't tell me, did I reach the objective already? No, it would seem not. So, yeah, I mean, there just isn't a lot of, stuff that, there is for me in these dungeons anyway, so... Hold up. Nope, nothing here. It just clears out like that. For no reason. No specific reason at all. Yep, thank you very much. How does it feel, human? I think I can actually attack it from here. I still do have it equipped, don't I? No, I don't. Ebony broadsword. I mean, do I really want to engage it? Yes, I can. Yay! I can attack you, but you can't attack me. Do you have anything for me? Of course you don't. At least you got a level of experience for me. Just 3 points? Seriously? Okay, so where do we want to put these points? I mean, I guess willpower would be a definite one. Oh, magic defense plus 3, damage plus 3. What else? Well, do we want a point of endurance? Do we want a point of personality? I guess luck would be another thing. I mean, right now my agility and strength are already at 100, so I doubt it matters much. I guess it's more of a battle between endurance and speed. And I shall put this point in speed. So, let's see where it goes from here. I'll just save here. And there was something here the last time, wasn't there? I would really like to see what that is. Wait, what is this thing? What is this? Is this like a mummy of some sort? And why is it stuck in the wall? Ah, it's a stone golem. What is in pieces and an iron longsword? Well, that was something. I guess that's just one of the things which appears here, out of nowhere. I'm just gonna save because I don't really feel like going head to head with that again, so yeah. What the? When, where the fuck do you guys come from anyway? Hold up. It would suck if I died again. And I can already hear another stone golem. Nope, it's a hellhound. Because fuck my life. Resist fire? Do I want to? Yes, I will too. And where are you? All the way over there. Seriously, you're gonna check fireballs at me from all the way over there? And I do believe that this is how... Or rather, this is where... excuse me. The magic classes actually excel because they can practically fireball somebody's ass from a mile away. Okay, there's something here. It's... so difficult to see these things. they decided to attack me from both sides, and I can still hear them. I mean, one of them is here. And more rooms for me to go into, but I still don't know where the objective is. I mean, you told me to go southwest, and I went southwest, and unless there was something here which I missed, this place had nothing. I guess this is just going to be one of those dungeons where I have to spend all my time exploring until I actually finally stumble into the objective. Or so I would suppose. Yep. Somebody... How is it that a stone golem throws lightning though? I mean... Yep, that is another stone golem. Where is it? Or was it this thing? Nope, it is a stone golem. And I do believe I should equip my dwarven whatever this is. Oh shit, I've been using this sword all along. Well, at least its condition is still new. Worn. Wow. I do suppose these guys should have like a... Thank you for dying. Useless column with nothing unusable. Sorry, nothing usable. I'm so glad that this game actually has a map feature, because if it didn't, then life would be a lot. Scratching in the wall, here's a short message. Where the Emperor, his minions await me. A strange message to find within these depths. So I guess they... When he said southwest, he meant northeast? Like northeast? Because that is where we are headed right now. Huh. I guess we'll just save here. In the honor of this message. Hold up. Yeah, I'm gonna deal with you later. I shall just follow this long ass passage somewhere over here. Let me just check. What is it up there? I mean, this seems to be a pretty tiny room, if you don't mind me saying that. Is this like a resting area of sorts? Yes, it is! Unless, you know, there are ranged classes here, which is a total possibility. I guess we can try going this way. Huh. Skeevers? Of all things, skeevers? Or rather, rats. I mean, to be technically correct as far as this game is concerned. Oh, hello there. Time for you to die. Yeah, I mean, this maze doesn't really do that bad. Isn't that bad when it comes to damage. Oh my god. Nothing usable. But at least I'm getting more gold. Huh. And there is a lot of lava here. And you know what the worst part of this game is? No, I mean not this game, this level. I just hope that I don't have to actually swim in the lava to get where I have to go. Because that would suck. That would really suck. Huh. So, I guess we start making our way back to the front, I suppose. And following a clue, we ended up coming back full circle. The secret of the staff is mine. I guess that's the writings of that lunatic guy. I mean, I guess he sort of did go insane, you know, obsessed with the staff touched by Shogorath. But yeah, I mean, have we come full circle yet? Yes, we have. Guess what? Luck is a bitch. We haven't exactly checked this side, so I guess I might do that then. You know what? I'm not gonna waste another potion of levitation. What I will do is take this path here. Don't fall into the writing ends abruptly, as if the writer was suddenly interrupted. The wicked shall, the secret of the staff is mine, the wicked shall around you lies pools of seething lava, welling up from deep below and releasing the gases into the air, which seems tainted but breathable. Yeah, sulfur. I guess this is the path that we were meant to take, and we just, you know, skipped it all and went our own way, where we weren't supposed to go, so yeah, I guess it sort of makes sense. Do we want to cross and explore this area? Let's jump ahead. Let's go ahead and jump across. Oh, come on. It's painful. Oh my god, that was close. As I was saying, it's painful enough that I have to, you know, press Shift and J together in order to jump. And on top of that, the cursor has to be out of this area here for me to jump. Take this path here. I mean, we can try it. There should be some way to, you know, cross over and explore this side here. Oh wait, there was a door here which I missed. How did I miss that? I'm so stupid. Maybe this is where the objective might be. Should we make our way over? I suppose we can. There's no harm in it. So, you see oceans of pool like this. So this is the type of pool that you can only cross if you're an acrobat or, a Khajiit. Other races just can't jump that far. But yeah, jumping accurately as an acrobat or a Khajiit is another thing which would take a bit of skill. Go in here and nope, we still have a bit of a way to go. I see a shadow emerging from there. And is this a door? Yes it is, oh my god. I'll just save here. You know, just in case. And a longbow which I cannot pick up, and a mark which I cannot pick up. It's just a loot room, nothing more. I mean, where's the objective though? Where's the thing that we came here for? Wait, what the f... Why did it get unequipped? Thank you. You would be challenged by this lock. By a lock? Seriously? Yeah, I should do that more often instead of just straight away starting by bashing these things. Ah, Blade Greaves. Okay, so here is where I'm going to save, and I shall be back. I mean, I don't know, it'll be up to editing me to decide whether or not I will be continuing this video from this point onwards, or, you know, like just breaking it into different parts. But yeah, that's a question for tomorrow. So, not tomorrow, I mean later. So, see you guys, I guess.